This is my latest project, Laser Light City, and it's the biggest one so far. You can use your phone to take control of massive sky lasers, and you can change their color, shape, and position. The software I built can handle thousands and thousands of connections at once, and the lasers can be installed on a single building or across the entire city. I'm often asked about how I get my projects together, so I thought it's about time I made a video about it. So if you'd like to know a bit more about the background of this project, how I learned how to rig lasers on tall buildings, and even how you avoid hitting airplanes with lasers, then stick around.
There appears to be an aircraft, I'm assuming a helicopter, because it's cold.
I'm Seb Lee-Delisle, and you've probably seen me around a bit.
Can this burn me?
Yeah.
Cool. Good save. But when I'm not helping other YouTubers, I make my own large-scale interactive laser projects. As you can see, my projects are usually big, but recently I've taken things up a notch. To understand how I got here, let's go back to the beginning of 2020. I built this prototype fireworks project called Electric Laser Flares, and this is the first time I've tested it out at the Spectra Festival in Aberdeen. I was all set to scale it up to the next level, build a whole bunch more of the light sticks, and do it at some really big events, and I already had two or three bookings for later in the year. But of course, we all know what happened next. It's 2 months since we've been in Aberdeen, and we're now in full lockdown. Although I'm not really sure what's going to happen later in the year, one by one, all of my electric laser flares bookings are getting cancelled. Everyone's applauding the NHS health service every Thursday, so I've decided to show my appreciation the only way I know how, with lasers. It's so nice to see such a good response. I think we're all a bit starved of entertainment right now. I'm wondering if there's something I can do with lasers that might work, even in the tightest lockdown. I'll have to get lasers that are big enough to be seen from miles away. I've got great news! I managed to get some emergency funding from the Arts Council to work on a new project, and in order to do that I've bought these two massive 30 watt lasers. I'm excited to give them a try. It's seriously scary running this laser in my workroom. I don't know if you can tell, but this is so, so bright. It's honestly a little bit intimidating. If the laser stops even for a moment, it starts burning stuff. I've got CAA clearance, so I can put this laser outside. Honestly, you know it's a serious laser when you can see the beam even in full daylight. It's just ridiculous. Goodness, you can really see the shape on the sky. You can see I'm using a mirror to bounce the laser up from horizontal to vertical. So I'm just heading out to see if I can see it from a bit of a distance. Tonight it's a lot more of a stronger effect, and that's the laser that's going away from the house, but you can see if I turn on the laser that's coming towards us, that's even more impressive because it's sort of coming overhead. I think that's looking pretty good. So the third week. Okay, it's like the best one I've done. I haven't bounced it off a mirror today,
I was kind of worried about bouncing up from here, and not only do you lose a bit of the brightness, but also you have a very limited area. You can see it's just like flying around the entire city. That really shows up. Yeah.
That's a lot of work from the beach.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got bored, so I was like, I'm here to see what I like.
Cool. And we've got a brilliant night for humidity. I think it's about 80% humidity. And I don't know if you can see, but the beam is like cutting through really brilliantly. I'm also doing a test of the new server setup. So I think there's a cluster of about 4 servers. And it's expandable, and this is the first time I've tested that. The UI needs a lot of work, but all seems to be holding up pretty well so far. Yeah, it's cool. I just can't get over that visibility, really. That's the most visible it's been this entire time. Okay, so that is about 1500 meters away.
Week 5, and the software's nearly finished. You can see I've redesigned the interface. You've got 4 different options for shapes and 4 different options for colours. I've also implemented a queuing system, so if someone's currently using the lasers, then you join a queue. I'm also live streaming it, which means I can reach more people across the country, and I can also give the system a much better workout than if I was just relying on Brighton people. Of course, the British summertime, it's raining so hard, but actually this project looks so good in the rain. Just instant sparkles. Lots of big news this week. We've had our first big booking confirmed for Light Night Leeds. It's not until October, but they want this project on a huge scale. 7 different sites. So I've decided to take some of the Arts Council money and put on a larger test event in Brighton in preparation for Leeds. That will be in a few weeks. I've got lots more software development to do, lots more testing. And of course I need to pull together a really big crew. I think I'm going to need like 15 to 20 people for this one. Coming up in the next episodes, our Brighton test event, our enormous Leeds installation, and the opportunity to install on a beautiful Victorian Sussex pier.
Yeah.
Laserlight City is going on tour in autumn 2021. If you know anyone, any organisation, any buildings, any companies that might be interested in booking us, please get in touch via my website at seblee.co. I'll see you on the next episode.